Good evening, folks. I'm Brooke. Thanks for tuning in to Chem Corner this evening. Tonight, we have a special report on bioluminescence. And here with us is a marine biologist who goes by the name of Bio Betty.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for having me. Today, I'm going to be talking about the chemistry of bioluminescence. I also have a special guest with me today, all the way from the Atlantic Ocean.
Before you bring your guest out, we have a few questions to ask. The first question is, what is bioluminescence?
I'm glad you asked that because most people don't know what bioluminescence is. Bioluminescence is light produced by a chemical reaction within a living organism.
The second question we have for you is, what are some of the organisms with bioluminescence?
Some organisms that are bioluminescent include jellyfish, lanternfish, vampire squid, firefly, and anglerfish, which is what I have here with me today. Most bioluminescent organisms are found in the ocean, which include fish, bacteria, and jellies, but some are found on land, which include fireflies and fungi. There are no freshwater bioluminescent organisms.
Our third question we have is, how do these organisms use bioluminescence to their advantage?
Bioluminescence is used by living organisms to hunt prey. Anglerfish use the long illuminated filament on their head to lure prey. Small fish only see the giant jaws behind the bright light too late. An example is from Finding Nemo, when Nemo and Dory run into the anglerfish. They're attracted by the illuminated light, but they see the jaws too late until the fish is trying to attack them.
Our final question we have for you is, what chemicals are required in the chemical reaction of bioluminescence?
That's actually one of my favorite questions. The chemical reaction that results in bioluminescence requires two unique chemicals. These are luciferin and either luciferase or photoprotein. Luciferin is the compound that actually produces light. In a chemical reaction, luciferin is called the substrate. The bioluminescence color is a result of the arrangement of luciferin molecules. Luciferase is a generic term for the class of oxidative enzymes that produce bioluminescence and is distant from a photoprotein. Photoprotein is basically the protein that activates the emission of light in organisms. Some bioluminescent organisms produce luciferin on their own, but some do not produce luciferin. They absorb it through other organisms either as food or in a symbiotic relationship. Luciferase is an enzyme. The interaction of luciferase with oxidized luciferin creates a byproduct called oxyluciferin. The chemical reaction creates light. Most involve luciferin and luciferase, but some do not involve an enzyme. These involve a chemical called photoprotein. Photoproteins combine luciferins and oxygen, but need another agent, often an ion of the element calcium, to produce light.
Wow, thanks for sharing that interesting information. Would you like to bring out your guest?
Yes, I'd love to. And now's the moment you've all been waiting for, Annie the Anglerfish!
Well, I don't like to brag, but anglerfish are actually pretty cool critters. We may not be the most attractive in appearance, but we live in the dark depths of the sea, so our prey and predators don't have to see us very often. As a physical trait, female anglerfish have a lure attached to the top of their head. This lure can be maneuvered in all directions. Like Bio Betty said, anglerfish are bioluminescent, but they don't produce their own light. The top of the lure is bulb-like and produces bioluminescent light from photobacterium. Photobacterium enters the bulb part of the lure through pores. Anglerfish use bioluminescence to lure prey and mates. Photobacterium is an organism that produces its light from photoproteins, like Bio Betty explained. The photobacterium and the anglerfish share a symbiotic relationship. This means both the anglerfish and photobacterium benefit from one another. I am able to produce light, and the bacterium are safe from predators up in my lure. Like I said, I use this lure in many different ways, including finding a mate. Male anglerfish are extremely small, so when I do find a mate, he will latch onto me and fuse into my body. He will then lose all internal organs and we will share a bloodstream. Do you have any other questions for me tonight?
Thanks for tuning in to Chem Corner. go.
Thanks for tuning. You guys didn't do it.
Photobacterium produces light from.
You do have a great cartoon voice, I can tell you that.
Ways, including finding a mate. Male anglerfish are extremely small, so when I do find the mate, he will latch onto me and fuse into my body. Pause.
And that's the moment you've all been waiting for, Andy the anglerfish!
Exactly is bioluminescence.
Yes, that's great. Ask away.
Oh.
Okay.